Everyone, Daniel here from Twin Bytes with another tutorial for you, this time with regards to Google and their OAuth and the business apps. So if you're using Google Business or G Suite, they've changed the names, then this is there's an email here that you may have received that shows that starting on September 15th of next year, then the G Suite accounts will only allow access to apps using OAuth. And so that means that if you're not using Gmail directly, or on your phone, if you're not using the Google's native email program, then those are the only ways that your password would work. Otherwise, any other apps, including Microsoft Outlook, especially for businesses that they use that, your password won't work anymore. You need to create an app password, and that's what we're going to talk about in this video. And I'm going to show you exactly how to set this up. I'm going to show you how to do that. Coming right up. All right, so looking at the email here, if you receive something like this and it shows you that starting February 15th of 2021, the G Suite accounts will only allow access to apps using OAuth. So that means Gmail or the native email program on your phone. So if you're using Outlook on your computer or anything else, then that's not going to work for you. So it tells you here as well that starting June 15th of this year, which is 2020, any users who try to connect to the LSA, which is the less secure apps, for the first time will no longer be able to do so. So that means if you're trying to set up Outlook or setting up your Gmail in Outlook for the first time after June 15th, 2020, it's not going to work. But if you already have it going, it'll continue to work and it's going to be fine. So it's only if you're doing it for the first time, it won't work after this date. But for those that already have it set up, you're good until February of next year, 2021, and then it's going to stop working. And all of a sudden, you'll wonder, why is my emails not working in Outlook anymore, or my phone, the emails aren't working? Well, if you're not using the native program, then that's why, and you need to set up an app password, and I'm going to show you how to do that. So this email gives you a fair bit more detail if you were to read through it here, and it tells you what you need to do, and it gets into a little bit of detail with it, but it can be very overwhelming for a lot of people on how to do this. So let's look at how to change this. So if we go into your Gmail, for example, just go to gmail.com, and you don't want to go through the settings cogwheel here, but click on the letter for your name, and then you can click on that and go down to manage your Google account. So once you get into here, over on the left side, there's security. So we click on that, and under here we've got signing into Google. Now you've got your password, and it tells you the last time it was changed, which is great. It's good to know how long it's been since you changed your password last, but anyway, that's going a little bit off topic. You could have your phone to sign in. There's a two-step verification, and then there would be another option underneath this two-step verification to set up your app passwords, but that's not visible right now. And the reason for that is because we need to first set up two-step verification. So if you're not familiar with how to set up two-step verification, I've got a video that I'll link to up here that I've already made that shows you exactly how to do that. So we'll just get this on, and then I'll show you what happens next. Okay, so I had to set up the two-factor authentication on this particular account, and now what we want to do is go back to the main screen. So if you already had two-factor authentication set up, you'd be fine, but if you had to just set it up, There's a little arrow beside the two-step verification at the top. We can go back. And so now we can see here that two-step verification is on, and we now have app passwords available. So as I said, if you already had two-step verification turned on, you will already be seeing the app passwords. So now all we need to do is click into this and set that up. So I had to enter the password and get to this next screen. So basically what we want to do is click into select an app, and you can choose from a few different things. So if you're using the mail program in Windows, or if it's calendar or contacts, they have specific things there. YouTube even. Now what we want is to use other or custom name. So in this case, maybe we're using Outlook in the Windows and you need to have that going. So we can call it Outlook. Okay. And we'll hit generate, and it generates the code for us here. And it tells you here that you need to put that in your into the program. So if it's Outlook, we're just copy that and hit done, and now it shows that we have one app set up and we labeled it what we want to call it, when it was created, and when it was last used. You can't really see what the password is, so there's no way of going into it and revealing the password. So if you ever lost that, what you would have to do is just trash it here and then go through to create another one, and just the same procedure again. So with this, now you can go into Outlook in that example and go to where your password is and delete the password that's in there currently. Even if it's already working, you can delete it out of there and put in the password that you just copied out of here, and that should continue to work for you. And then after the cutoff date next year, when they finally enforce this so less secure apps won't be on anymore, then your email will still continue to work. So if you're not sure about the less secure apps, it would be on this screen further down near the bottom, but it's not visible now because we have two-step verification turned on. So as soon as you have two-step turned on, the less secure apps, or LSA they call it, is just, it's disappeared. It's not even there. So if you turn off two-step verification, you have the LSA available where you can turn on the switch and have that either on or off. So I just turned off the two-step briefly here so that we can go down and look at this. And now we see less secure apps access. And right now it is turned on. This is what a lot of people may already have, including you. You may have this turned on because Outlook wouldn't work because it's not a recommended program. So because it's considered a less secure app, which is why they call this to allow less secure apps, you would have to allow less secure apps like Outlook to have access. So we could turn this off and go back. So less secure apps is off. So then Outlook wouldn't be working because we're not allowing the less secure apps. But allowing Outlook to work through here means that you're allowing all kinds of other programs to work, which means any hacker that gains your password, they could use that to start working with. So the best thing to do is just ignore the less secure apps completely, turn on the two-step verification, and then create your app password, and using that going forward, you will be a lot more secure. So thanks to Google for being really on top of the security. That's it for this tutorial. Please, if you found it helpful, give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and stay tuned for our future videos. All right, thanks so much. Bye for now.